Did you ever protect your Excel sheets and then forget your password? It happened to me twice. If it's happened to you, comment below, let me know. Now, I know there are tools out there that can remove the password, but I'd rather do it without any random third-party tool. There is a way you can do it yourself. You can hack your own file. You just have to follow these simple steps. I have this Excel file with four different tabs. This tab here, the data tab, has protection in place. So if I attempt to change something here, I can't. If I want to delete the chart or move the chart, I can't. I can't move these radio buttons, but I can use them. Right? So I added this protection in place because I didn't want anyone to mess with this data, but unfortunately, I've forgotten my password. So if I go to review an Unprotect sheet and try to guess my common passwords that I use, it just doesn't work. This one has a different password. Now, I can copy and paste this information somewhere else, but then I have to revise my chart. I have to make sure the chart ranges work correctly. It's going to be a headache to set this up from scratch. And you might have protection on sheets that are really complex and are connected to many other sheets. You probably don't want to set that up all from scratch. Here's what you can do. Let's close this. This is my file. Next thing I'm going to do is to create a copy of this. So I really recommend you do this because it's very easy to corrupt your file. Okay, so now I have a copy. Then I'm going to go ahead and remove the extension. Instead of .xlsx, I want .zip. Now click away and it's going to tell me, are you sure that you want to do this because your file might become unusable? I'm going to go with yes. Next step is to open this in the zip program that you have installed. So in my case, I have WinRAR. You might have something else. If you don't have a zip program, there are some for free that you can use. The most popular one, I think, is 7-Zip. I'm going to add the link to that in the description of the video. Then just double click on this to open this, and you should see the components of your spreadsheet. The folder you need to go to is the Excel folder. Next, go to the Worksheets folder. Here you should see a separate XML file for each worksheet. My sheet that was protected was the second worksheet. If I open this, how does it look? It looks kind of scary, but don't worry about this. What we need to search for is Protect, you know, just to make sure that I've spotted the right sheet. So if I look for Protect, I see this code here. It says Sheet Protection, and then it has all of this part here. This means I found the right sheet. So if you open something that doesn't have Protect in there, so sheet 3 doesn't have protection, if I look for the word Protect, it tells me no match is found. It doesn't have protection in place, right? So this is what you can use to see if you've found the right sheet that you want to unlock. Now, you can't make any changes directly. What you need to do is drag this to your desktop. Basically, you're creating a copy of this, then right mouse click, and open it with the editor or notepad. Now, it doesn't look as neat and organized as before, but it doesn't matter. All we need to do is find that protection part. So just search for Protect. I can see it right here. So this here is the part that I need to remove. Now, here you have to be extra careful that you select the right part. Now, I'm going to start from this angled bracket here and go all the way to where it closes. So just slowly go through this and I can see the closing part right here. Okay, so select this and select the closing bracket and just remove this. Now we're going to save this. So close and save. The changes were done in the copied version. So I want to bring the copy over. But first of all, I'm going to remove the old version. So I'm just going to press delete to remove that. Now I'm going to drag and drop it here. And go with OK, so it adds it right here. Okay, everything looks good. Let's close this. And now we're going to change this from zip back to XLSX. Click away. Are you sure? Yes. Okay, so now let's test. I'm going to open the file. Let's see if I can add anything here. I can. I can change numbers. I can move my chart around. I can update the radio buttons. The sheet is now unprotected. Now I can go ahead and protect this again with a password that I'm going to remember. Just go back to Protect Sheet, put in your password, confirm it, and now you have a password that you can hopefully remember. I hope you successfully managed to unprotect your sheet. Don't forget to make that backup though. The first time I did this, I deleted something else by mistake and my file got corrupt. So do take that copy before you do this. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this. Do subscribe for more office tips and tricks, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.